The first thing I would like to ask is, you know, what do you have like a family? Do you have like a wife and kids or anything like that? Or what's your situation there?
Yeah, so I have a wife. We have a non-government marriage, because I guess I was already libertarian when we decided to do that. We've got two little four-legged kids.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, everybody asks, what kind of dogs are those? And I'm like, well, they're Texans, I guess. Because they're like these, we got them from the pound, and like, you know, it's the same story with like all the dogs there. Like, yeah, we found them on somebody dumped them on the side of the road, and for some reason this breed is really popular there. And it's like they're like small, they're bigger than a Chihuahua, but like smaller than Dachshund. We think one of them is half Chihuahua and the other one's half Dachshund.
Oh, gosh.
But yeah, so we just call them Texans, because like when I was campaigning in 2014, I'm like going door to door knocking on people's doors, and I saw so many of these dogs.
Oh, yeah.
Like, you know, very similar, all like very different and distinct, but very similar, just, you know, small, dark, and friendly. So,
well, there you go. Awesome. Okay.
You have that, like, answers the question of dog or cat too.
Yeah, definitely. I used to be a cat person, but I'm, yeah, I, after seeing how people have to live with the litter box, I was just like, no, nope. Can't
you
do
have,
that.
You have like a cute story of how you met your wife?
Yeah, actually, that's a great story. So it was, I was hanging out with my friends in LA, and one of them was like, yeah, it's my sister's birthday. Well, it wasn't actually his sister's birthday, but he figured that was the only way he could get us to come. It was actually my wife's birthday. And she was a friend of my friend's sister. So we didn't care. We were going out, we were partying, and we met, and we just kind of hit it off. And you know, we just went, that was back when I was kind of just going to clubs all the time. So we started going to clubs together, and we went to a bar, and this, I can't even remember the name of it because I would love to put them on blast, but in LA, like, these bars would like shut down every 2 months, and like just like someone else would come in and rename it with a new design and everything. We went in there when I went to close out my tab, they lost my credit card and my driver's license. I was like,
Oh
man.
no.
And they told me, like, yeah, well, here's the number of the manager, you can call back. And I tried calling, and like, they would never return my calls. They would, you know, and I was like, okay, this sucks. And it's no big deal, right? It's like, I got to pay $20 to the DMV, but it's like, I got to go down there and wait. Like, so it was just like a bunch of headache. So I was like, man. So I went back there one night with my wife. We weren't married at the time, but we went back, and I was just like, man, like, I was like, I'm gonna knock on the door, like, whatever I gotta do, let me talk to the manager. So I went to the, we got in, I went to the bartender, I said, I need to talk to the manager right now. And the guy finally came out, and I told him what happened. I'm like, look, I was here last week, you lost my driver's license, you lost my credit card, what are you gonna do about it? And he's like, okay, well, he goes and he talks to the bartender, and he says, okay, they're gonna pour you two drinks on the house. And I'm like, okay, that's something, right? So they pour us two drinks, which normally would be like $10 each, so that's $20. And I'm thinking, like, okay, so that kind of covers the cost of having to get a new license, but there's like 10 cents worth of alcohol in there, right? Let's be honest. So I was like, okay, you know what, I ordered another couple drinks, and then we drank them, and I was just like, hey, let's get out of here. And so we started walking, and then like security just like, they started yelling, like, hey, get those guys, you know. So they got us both handcuffed. And the manager came out, and he was talking shit to me, and he's like, I said one free drink, not two. And I was like, what are you gonna do about it? It was funny, because like, this girl who I just kind of met was like really like on board with the idea of like, yeah, fuck these guys who just ripped us off. And I was like, that was the moment I knew she was the one. And I was in handcuffs, and she was in handcuffs, and it was fun. Yeah, and what's really interesting is, as much as I hate government, I use the government's rules against this guy, because he's sitting there, I'm in handcuffs, he just reaches into my pocket, takes my wallet out, and he's like, well, I see you have a lot of credit cards here, maybe I'll just charge it to one of these. And I was like, well, you can do that if you like getting chargebacks, which, for people who don't know, like, that goes against your business, and you get enough chargebacks, which bars probably get a lot, then your rates go up, or they shut down your account, you can't accept credit cards. So he was just like, okay, I'm gonna put this back over here. How about if I just bash your head into that pole instead? And I said, well, That would be fine if you want a felony investigation on you, which is going to mean that your alcohol license is suspended and you're going to have to shut down your business until the case is over, which could be years. Is that what you want? And he was like, okay. He was just like, get this guy out of my sight.
So, wow.
Yeah, that was fun. That was good times. But I don't recommend people go mess with thugs like that just because I know it can be dangerous. But hey, I was feeling young and adventurous, so.
That sounds like the ultimate, like, libertarian get-together.
Yeah, it really does.
And that was before I even knew, like, before I had even heard the word libertarian.
Right. I feel like it's in the blood. Like, everybody's a libertarian, they just don't know it yet.
Right.
But man, that's amazing. Is your wife a libertarian?
She's, yeah. So she was born and raised in Mexico. So she's like, she has the opinion that the government is corrupt, but she's kind of like, she's used to seeing like, oh, somebody wants to run for office, they get gunned down in the middle of the street. So she's kind of like, I wish you'd stop being so outspoken about it.
Right.
But you know, I used to be afraid to say taxation is theft, because I was like, I'm going to get audited by the IRS and they're going to take everything I have and get shot down by a SWAT team. And like, because this is like, you know, what do you know about the IRS? What you see on the internet, what you hear in like the propaganda and everything else.
Mm-hmm.
This was a real fear that I had. So, but it took me a while to like, at some point I was just like, man, like, fuck it. If I don't say anything, who will? And exactly. So and then like, as I start speaking and saying these things, I realize that like the fear is just that, it's mostly fear. There's like, especially in the US, I mean, as bad as it is, like, it's not like in Mexico where like you're going to get gunned down for having an opposing opinion. Now you might get, you might accidentally kill yourself with two bullets in the back of your head if you get too powerful with your message.
Yeah.
But that's another story. So that might be like further down in my campaign. We'll see.